please give us an idea of what's going on in the lung at the time?
It's essentially something very simple. It's inflammation of the airways, the pipes that carry the air from your mouth to the air sacs, where gas exchange takes place, where oxygen goes in your body and carbon dioxide comes out. And when you have inflammation of those tubes, it causes three things. It causes cough, dry hacking cough usually. It causes wheezing. Wheezing is a noise that's made when the bronchial tubes are narrowed a little bit. And it causes shortness of breath if it's bad, if the wheezing is bad, or if the secretions block up the bronchial tubes so that it's hard to move air. It's an airways disease. The airways are these tubes, these conduits. There are conduits for airflow. And they're dynamic. They're not fixed pipes like water pipes. They're dynamic. They have smooth muscle that causes constriction and narrowing of the bronchial tubes and relaxation and widening of the bronchial tubes. And that's supposed to happen functionally depending on what you're doing and what you're breathing and where you are, you know, based on altitude, whether you're breathing dust and what happens in asthma is that control is thwarted by an overreaction to the environment. And it can be a reaction to things that are normally there. It can be a reaction to things that shouldn't be there, like toxic chemicals or severe dust, like a dust storm or severe pollution. And you can see how this demonstration shows the lining of the lung here becoming very red. Usually it's pink, and when it gets bright red, it's because it's inflamed. And when it becomes very red, that swelling causes narrowing and the bronchial tubes close down, and which makes the trouble with breathing. And along with that, the body produces a lot of thick mucus to try and counteract the inflammation, which doesn't work out well because as the bronchial tubes trap the mucus, then the mucus causes further problems, and that's where patients really get into trouble and end up in the emergency room or in the hospital or having sudden death from asthma when it gets very severe.